My brother's got the first fish of the day. And then I got this little one. My brother's got another one. He's beating me pretty bad right now. My brother's got another one on the crankbait. I'm gonna have to switch over soon. I don't know. I'm about to go out in the kayak a little bit. Anyway, just got this like long and skinny bass. Right off the edge of that little weed line. He felt real big because he was in the weeds. But I got this one off of a wacky worm. We're about to go out in the kayaks on the next fish. My brother's got a nice bass on him. We haven't seen him yet. Yeah, that's a real nice bass. That could go five. Here, I'll get him. I'll get this. Oh yeah, this is seven. No.
Huh?
No. Six. I'd say six.
Okay.
Oh, that's a nice bass.
It's pretty big.
Just like, if you didn't estimate, my brother's like 6'2", 220 maybe. Right, somewhere around there. It's a nice bass. Oh yeah. We're done with the spawn here, so it didn't have any eggs. If it was a female, it'd probably be about 8-9 pounds. Holding up for us. Nice bass. Just got this bass right off that dock. We're out in the kayak now. My brother just had one on for a second and he got off. He caught one too and I didn't get him on camera, but kind of hard to camera and fish and all that stuff. So I'm not gonna get the tiny ones on camera. If they're under like 6 inches, they're not coming on camera. So I think that's about 10 for us so far. I just got this really long skinny bass right up in there. It's a falling down tree right there. Underwater and I got him on a wacky worm. With one big bite baits, wacky worm has lasted me like 5 fish. And they're only 99 cents at Academy, so it's not all about that Gary Yamamoto Senko crap. Because, you know, I'm tearing them up pretty good on this little 99 cent pack of worms. Alright, the winds are starting to pick up. We might go to the land or something, I don't know, get out of the wind somewhere. But I just got this one on a lizard. Black and blue. Right there. My brother just got this nice one off these little grass mat things on a 10-inch power worm. My brother got another 3-pounder just about 5 minutes after that last one. We came over here, we were just sitting in these weeds because the wind's pushing us away, but there's a bunch of bees flying around back in there, so gotta watch out for those. But that's a nice bass. He's caught a few threes and about 5 to 6 probably. My brother over there, he just got another nice bass. He's using that 10-inch power worm. I'll switch back over to a wacky rig because I only caught one on a lizard. But yeah, so we're sitting in these weeds because really not much of an option. The wind calmed down a little bit, so we might move out of here and go troll along the banks again. But we'll get back to you with some more bass. I just got this bass right up in there. You know, everybody get that feeling when you know you're just going to catch one right there? Well, I pitched right back there as far back to the left as I possibly could. I said, that's a bass right there. As soon as I said that, pop. Set hook on him, pulled him out of there. Hope I can get some more on this dock. Looks pretty promising. My brother just got one on a crankbait out there. My brother's got one all the way across there. My brother's over there with a 3.5-pounder on a crank. All right, my brother's.
This has got a big mouth.
Yeah.
Got it?
Yeah, it's about a 5. Maybe more. I don't know. It's longer. You got a bigger mouth than the other one that we caught earlier. But not as big of a belly. It's a nice bass.